weer een family of four. Liv, Vic, Björn en Annelies. En weer traveling for a year through Europe by bike. And we decided to do this to get out of the rat race from home and spend more time with our family.
At home we are both working full time, and then before you know it, the kids are grown-ups, and then yeah, you miss the quality time with them during their childhood. So if you could do that in combination with traveling and the things you love, like bicycles and yeah, being outside, we just made the decision to go through with this.
We're traveling a lot by bicycle. Every holiday in the summer we traveled by bicycle, and then at the moment we wanted to go longer and take a year off, and we were dreaming about it a long time. I think almost a year that we were saying, yeah, we will do it, we will do it. And one time the girl said, how is it? Are we going to do it or not? Because I need to know. And then we said together, yes, we will do it.
Yeah.
The last day of the school year, the 30th of June, we picked them up from school with our bikes and we headed up.
So we try to follow the weather. So meaning during the summertime we do the countries of the north. So we started off in Belgium, then we went to England, Scotland, took the ferry to Northern Ireland, then down the south to Ireland, France, and then the north of Spain, Portugal, the south of Spain. And now we are in Italy, and that's what we did up to now. Yeah. So that's 10 months of cycling.
And in the future, the next few months, we will fly to the Baltic states and to Scandinavia. And we will end up in Denmark. But our route has changed a lot during our journey. We always change ideas and optimize it. The biggest benefit is for us to spend a lot of time with our family. So this was our main goal. Even on the bicycle, you would think that the children would not like the cycling, but we're riding on a tandem, so we have a lot of time to speak to each other, and they like to be with us. And they're also still at the age that we are still their heroes, so they like spending time with us, and that's really, really nice. And we also switch bike, so we spend time apart with both child, and it's very nice. This is our closet. This one is of Vic. We have some waterproof compression bags. These are the clean clothes. The dirty clothes are in the rest of the bag. And we put them on their bikes. So everybody has a bag of his own. This is Vic. For the homeschooling, in Belgium it's easy to do homeschooling. You just have to fill in a paper and then you can do a year of homeschooling. So we sat together with the school, we bought also all the books. When the books are finished, we throw them away because they are a lot of weight. But we divided it into pieces and we said every month you have to finish a piece. So they can choose what they're doing, maths or languages, but they know they have to finish their book or their chapter at the end of the month. And it goes well, they become really independent.
They also are aware about time management and things like that, so something that they don't get at school, I think. And also when we are on the bike, for example, the boy has to do the tables of multiplication. So he's really an expert now, I think. He knows that his tables better than his mates at school, because we are doing it every day. It's like a game on the bike, so it's really nice.
In the preparation, we made our budgets.
Originally we thought it will cost about
84 euros a day, we said, but now we're at 67 at the moment.
So we are spending less than we actually thought it would.
For four people, indeed. In Europe.
In Europe, and we're also doing the northern countries, England and Scotland. And like Italy is also not that.
No. But I think we can go cheaper, but why would we? we also want to enjoy or go to a restaurant when it's raining and we're cold. And
very important, we also made the kids aware about the budget, so they are also they know they don't always have to ask an ice cream or a Coke, or we want to go to that swimming paradise, or this, they're really involved in the budget, so they also are aware.
Before we started, we said we're going on a journey and not on a holiday. On a holiday you get an ice cream every day, and on our journey not. And we sold also one car, and our house, my brother is living in it, so we get a little bit of money from that.
Yeah, you just have to do your homework and then decide what's the budget, and then you live to the budget. So that's why we are camping in a tent and not going from hotel to hotel or hostel to hostel. So that makes it also fun, because then you go wild camping and people invite you to their homes and things like that. The money shouldn't be the issue, I think, to make the decision.
But the hardest thing about this whole journey was to make the decision to, because it wasn't easy to say, oh, we're going to do that. Because when we first talked about it, it was, and what with the school, and what with our money, and you don't have an income. But for everything is a solution, and you just have to decide, we will do it and we will solve it.
They are joking about, I like doing this, but not with my wife and two kids. I just would like to do this with friends and not with with my kids. Or, because you're really close together all the time, 24 hours a day. Yeah, that's something new, because when you're at home, you work and they have their hobbies and their own friends. But now you're really stuck with the family. Up to now. It goes really well.
The hardest thing we experience, or I experience, is bad weather when you're cold. And also, we didn't expect that the winter would be so hard. Because in the winter we were in Spain, and during the day it's nice weather in Spain, but it becomes dark at 5. You have to see that everything is done before it's dark, and our days were very short. And the evenings are long. We spend a lot of time in the tent with the near reader.
Yeah, that's something you don't realize when you're at home with all the luxury of lighting and being at home with the heating on. If you're outside in the winter, and even we spent winter in the south of Spain, where it's supposed to be the best weather of Europe during winter, you still have cold and also the shorts. If you start something like this, like the kids, you don't know how they are going to react, if they're going to be a little bit homesick or missing their friends. But it's our little secret secret that we don't miss our friends that much. It's also, of course, it's 14 months, so you know it's limited in time, so you know that you go back and you will meet them again, and it's not to reduce the amount of toys, we decided to give every kid a Ziploc bag. So this is the amount of toys that they can bring along. So when the bag is full, they have to decide which toy to take out and replace it by a new toy. So this way you reduce or keep the weight within limit. It was nice talking to you guys. You can follow our journey on www.analyze.be, and maybe see you on the road. Bye.
Bye.